Hi there. So I was gonna do the second part of this, but I've sort of like stuck with it, I think. I don't know. I was unsure whether to change that or take the hand out there, or I don't know. I'm gonna fit that in. I don't know. Little corner bits. I could do one, or maybe I could do the design separate and then multiply it, duplicate it, put it in the other corner. Shrink it. I don't know, to be honest. And also, I don't know whether like inking a hair or just leaving a bald, like a bald demon. I don't know. Little design elements, a little heart shape there, just to put, the nine carved into a head, so it's like the nine of hearts. I don't know. I've sort of got stuck with it, so I don't know. I think I won't continue with this one. I'll draw something else. And just keep on drawing, keep on sketching, and I can come back to it. That usually happens with some drawings, and it is a bit annoying, but it's part of what happens. I just need to think more about it. Maybe ink that hand, I don't know. Still thinking about it at the moment. Design problems. That usually like stops me from drawing sometimes. Oh well, I'll sketch something else. So I think I'm just finding I'm having one of them days. I'm doing a quick sketch here, but I think I'll just save it and continue with it another time. It was going to be like a weird like undead sort of pin-up type picture of like a skeleton woman, and yeah. I don't know, it's a crazy idea, but I can probably pick that up another time. Just having one of them days. So what I might do is just go through some older drawings and try and do a bit of them just for this Sunday vlog. And yeah, that's about it. So, but I can always come back to that and some other drawings at a later time. So I was just checking through some of my old artwork, and I just totally forgot about these two, the mummy sort of pieces that I did. Similar sort of, the way they look. This one's more detailed. I think this was the first one that I did. I think that was back when I was at this like art, sort of like meet up thing, and I just went to town with loads of details, totally over the top details, but I still like it. And I think this was the first one I did, the quick one, but yeah, I really like them. I just forgot that I actually did them. That sounds weird, but I draw a lot, so it's crazy that I've just forgot about certain bits of artwork, and there's some other bits of artwork that I forgot about as well, but it's crazy. Yeah, but like these would have looked good on that comic book that I've got, the blank sketch comic book. You've got like all detail, like maggots falling off and everything, and rotten bandages and stuff like that. I like the way I did that. Even this one, which is not as detailed, but well, the faces, I suppose, and the rest is okay. But I wanted to try and work out a lot of the bandages on the head. I remember when I did that, because I did that one almost like a little hat, and it wasn't really connected to the rest. So I wanted to correct that and do this drawing. I think I can't remember which one I did first, but yeah, it's nice looking back on some drawings that I forgot about. I could try and maybe colour one of these. I'll probably leave this one black and white for now. This one looks like it could be a lot of room for a load of color and things like that. So yeah, it's just good to find drawings you've just forgot about. So it's now the next day, after a totally uninspiring day yesterday. So I've got an idea for something, but it's the usual type of horror stuff. But it's like the thing inspired. I want to draw two heads that are sort of like melded together, pretty much like them conjoined, like demon skull things that I drew a couple of days ago. But this is more more connected, I'd say, like two halves of a face, just connected. Yeah, so that's what I want to try and draw. Sketch the elements that we want. Two faces. With the certain elements, I'll just erase on the top there. Just trying to flesh everything out, the shape of everything. The teeth, I want to give them like gaps in the teeth, like they're being stretched, you know, onto the other sort of side. So, I'm just trying to work this one out. Sort of working how I want it, really. Just about adding more detail. Like totally stretching the sort of faces together. So that iconic sort of image from The Thing, where the there's like two heads, like sort of like melded and stretched together, like silly putty or something, you know, where it's, you know. I tried to draw that a few times, and this is another sort of variation of that. Draw the eyeball looking inwards a bit. Eyeball looking inwards. So yeah, yesterday was a bit of a sort of like artist block, where I couldn't decide what I wanted to do or concentrate on. So I think times like that, you just need to just take a break, and that's what I did. Watch crappy telly for a little bit. crap programs on TV, and just had a break. So this is going to be a longer sort of a video, where I'm working this drawing out a bit more. Maybe the, I forget the tongue in there, just stretched. And I thought I'd just include that nose there, like that's been stretched as well. Just mad looking sort of thing. There's the initial pencil sketch. We'll zoom in and try and work on a bit more shadowing and things like that, and just try and flesh it out a bit. Flesh it out. So I just like the sinister looking look on the faces of these two, like joining together. It's a good thing to draw. It's just working out some of the inclines that I want to keep. I think the nose there is pretty much how I wanted it anyway. So and the eyes and that and the teeth, I think it's pretty much how I wanted it, all of it. So lines, try and fill it out a bit, the drawing. Right now I just want to do all the line work, and then I'll probably work on adding shading a bit later on. Just want to place everything in the lines. I like the way that even the teeth there look slightly distorted as well. So you can work on that. See if it is like the thin creature will distort all organic sort of matter and things like that. I did do a drawing of this, I think, about a year ago or something, and I liked it at the time, but no, I think sometimes you have to redraw some things just to get it, you know, how you want. And that drawing looked a bit more cartoony than I wanted, really, so I want this one to be not really realistic, but just looks a bit more like an illustration and not like a bit of a cartoon. So that's why I'm working on a lot of the line work here first, just to get everything put in place. What you'll notice is lots of twisting, like lines, that I'm trying to go with the flow of the, you know, like if there was two faces like joining together, they'd like stretch and sort of like flow together, sort of thing. So that's what I'm trying to go for. Jagged broken teeth as well, just helps adding something to the mix. I always think them molar teeth, the chewing teeth, always look like popcorn to me when I draw them. I don't know why. I suppose it does. Anyway. Follow some sort of line that I did there. Yeah, just trying to work it all out. Let's draw that ear. I say the ear is the ear and the eyes are the most normal things. I suppose the teeth, but the rest is all just twisting together. Try and work out the shape of the head. That's twisting together. Oh, I forget about this jaw. Real wobbly looking lines. Try and connect everything together now. Be a lot of under flaps of skin under this bit. Remember, there's going to be a bit of shadow under that bit, and just more lines as and when we need them. Try and build it all up. Stretched looking tongue. Those in there. What's the lines? Flowing lines. Yep, so I'll just move the camera up a little bit to see the top of the head. You'll probably see that like one head looks bigger than the other. Trying to go for this one that's more in the background, so when I colour it, I'm going to be doing like some shadow lines here, like, and try and recede this bit in the background, so like it's twisted all together, but it's this one's more in the background and this one's at the forefront, if you know what I mean. That's the idea anyway. Some more extra lines. Yeah, so we know, just got the eyes to ink. Just ink them eyes. Now this is where I start to add a little bit more detail, just fleshing things out still.
caused some shadows as well once I add little areas. So you've got to work out the shadows, so there'll be some shadow in the nose there. The eyes and where the frown lines are. Some of these like grooves of flesh will be deeper than other bits, you know. So like I said, I wanted like this to be a good like fold of skin that gives like some shadow. Pieces of shadow, and it highlights the eyes as well. Once you shadow under the eyes, cross hatching or just hatching with the ink pen. Starting to add little details wherever I can, texture on the skin and things. That's important to do as you go along. See, the darker the under eyes, the more highlighted the eyeball is as well. Excuse me. Windy pops. It's because I got my little coffee here. There we go. I don't know why people do that after drinking a hot drink. It's crazy. Right, so yeah, adding loads of shadow under this eye. Try and work on building up shadows elsewhere on some of these lines. Sort of toying with the idea of adding loads of rotten texture to this, just to make it, I don't know, more different from the thing creature, maybe like rotten flesh as well. Don't know. Good work. Yeah, could work quite well actually. So what I'm going to do off camera is I'm going to do more shadowing in the mouth and other areas, cheekbones and stuff like that. Try and flesh things out, and we'll come back to it and see what else we can add to it. So as you can see, I've added a lot of shadowing in the mouth and, you know, more around the eyes, and I've started to add more shadow at the top here. Let's show you. So it's just about filling in areas and just adding more detail at the inking stage, really, and things like that. I'm gonna maybe switch to a few other thinner ink pens after just adding more of this cross hatching stuff. Then I'll, like, when I've got most of the inking out the way, I can erase all the pencil lines and start to add a bit more colour. Yeah, a bit more colour, there's no colour, but you know what I mean. Just add colour to it. Said, I'd like loads of detail, just random bits just to help. Leaving a lot of the white space in between the hatching is important for the colour stage as well, so it can add to the shadows and tones and things, so I just leave all that in there. Don't really want to fill any areas in totally black. So, it's a Monday. Walking Dead tonight. So by the time this uploads, I would have watched Walking Dead. Just quite like that TV show. So yeah, some details I really need to switch to the other thinner ink pens. Just trying, I'm working off camera there, but never mind. Never mind, never mind. Just trying to look what needs more detail. I'm going to switch to a different ink pen. Rid of that one. That was the 05, it's a bit thick, that one. I'm going to use an 01 just to do some thinner sort of lines. Is this one the one that's running out? Try this one. Keep mixing up the ones that have run out with the ones that haven't. So I think that's a bit better. And I can just add more finer details, and on the teeth as well I can do some cracks and stuff. So drawing more details that I never drew in the pencil sketch stage, because I think it's important to try and get the flow of these like strands of flesh or whatever, you know, stretched. So you do like curved lines at this side, and then as it goes over there in the, you know, because it's in the back, I want to do curved lines that way, so it shows it's like flowing over that way, if you know what I mean. Quite possibly a lot of these details will be like lost at the colour stage, but at least I know I've added all the detail that I, you know, wanted to add. So I think that's why I do it. Details are the fun part. So it needs a lot of fleshing out really, just to make it how I want, but I suppose that comes with time and patience. All these lines, just have to all flow. Some veins in the eyes there. Always a good little addition. And some veins there, but I'll just do a slight vein in that one. Minor details that really you can't really see, but I'm going to expand on this. But what I'm going to do now is I'm going to erase all the pencil lines and then get back to inking a little bit more off camera. Then we'll come back and try and add a bit of colour to this. So with some Copic markers now, I'm just using a darker warm grey 5 on the dark areas. I think these grey pens are the ones I use the most. It's for working out a lot of the grey tones and things. Try and work out a lot of the areas that need a lot of this grey tone. Again, I probably won't finish this because some drawings are never finished, but I get a lot of the good grey tones in. At least I've stuck with this one for a bit. Try and get a lot of the lines to flow as well. Just ink the eye there and the eye over there. Dark shadows. Yeah, just try and finish off some of the grey tone shadows, because like in the particularly like in the mouth, that's supposed to be like a real stretched looking tongue, and that the colour won't remain grey. It's just like a sort of like an undertone. So yeah, I'll need to get some refills for these Copics. I've got some already, but they're nearly, say, halfway. So like, I need refills for the refills. Which sounds a bit mad, but yeah, that's what I need. But I don't need them yet, so I've got a bit of time. So that's the Warm Grey 5. Keep that at the side, so because I may need that later. I've got Warm Grey 3 now. I want to fill in quite a lot of this white space, not all of it though. Just try and go with the flow of the all these fleshy bits. I'm gonna do a bit of undershadowing of the fleshy bits here. That'll be important later on. Probably add some grey on that whites of the eye there, just to tone it down a bit, and do the same on the other bit. Building up the grey tones like this is important. It's something I want to spend a lot of time on. So that's why I probably won't get to finish this in today's vlog, but so I've got to go and post some eBay stuff out. Got a post office. Run a few errands, sort of thing. Bit of shopping and all that, so that's why I got up early and I did this vlog. Try and get out of the way this morning, and then if I feel like it, I could continue this tomorrow in tomorrow's vlog and try and actually finish it. I don't know. Or I might finish it overnight, you never know. But that's if you've seen my vlogs, you'll probably think, no, you won't. So, yeah. So I'll probably have to add some darker areas of that Warm Grey 5 under there. But so I'll just fill some of this in with the Warm Grey 3 and just come back to it. Just try and pick these up. There we go. I always need filling up quick these. I just filled them up before I did this, but I'll have to fill them up again. I've got a warm grey one. I want to do a base coat on the teeth. Relieve a bit of the white space around the edge, because that'll be important to highlight the teeth. Popcorn tooth there. Bits of base colour in there, because I'm going to go over that with like a pale grape type colour, which will undercoat the tongue. In fact, I'll do that now. Pale grape is just like a light pink, and it's a really good light undertone. Helps separate from the, you know, greys. I gotta do all the basic lighter areas. The darker areas won't matter because I will be overlaying some reds and eventually like coloured pencils, but that'll come later. So you can see like a faint pink colour there, even on camera. I've got like a dull ivory colour now. I really want to try and work in a lot of different skin tones with this. That's why it'll take a while, so I don't anticipate in finishing this today in the vlog. In fact, it'll be nearly the end of the vlog, I reckon, so I'm just going to add some areas which I want highlighted for later on, and it's around the gums. I want to try and get the flow lines there around the teeth. Again, this is an undertone colour, so I can change it and go over it, but I want a lot of pink bloody flesh colours to go over it at the end. So I could do a part two, but we'll see, because by tomorrow I might be drawing something else, I don't know. You know what I'm like on this daily art vlog. I think in between the daily art vlogs I need to be finishing stuff, because there's always this sense of urgency to get stuff finished when I'm on filming these art vlogs. And a lot of the times that's not the case, you know, I have to finish stuff. And each run on the camera lasts 8 minutes, so once 8 minutes go, it runs out, so I try and stop the camera before and edit it all together, you know, like it's normal. But yeah, I forgot even what I was talking about. Yeah, so what I need to do is work on adding more greys and things, and grey tones, maybe make the areas darker in the eyes. Still, even though I add them darker, I can go over them with coloured pencil at the end, but I want to work on a lot of the tones. So I think I definitely will leave this there and just try and work on these drawings in between vlogs. Like I said, I think that's the best way of doing things, because I can't just work on stuff on the vlog and try and finish stuff, because it isn't working that way. So Yeah, I'm going to try and finish stuff in between. Even if I have to be sat on the toilet, pushing out a turd, I'm still drawing and watching programs on telly. Yeah, sketch, draw, finish stuff. But I like the way this one's looking so far. The bottom part of the head looks even, better than that top half. But it all fits together, so I quite like it. I like the way it, looks, sort of thing. Yeah, so I may come back to this, like I said, or I may not tomorrow, but who knows? I may just show you a quick update on more work done, I don't know. So, thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. Cheers now!